In this second video series, we're going to look at electric fields. Now, a charged particle experiences a force in the presence of another charged particle. And we know that from Coulomb's law. But why is that so? It is because there's a field that pervades the space around a particle. It's a vector field, say, as opposed to a temperature field in a room. Now, the electric field near a charged object can be measured by changing, by placing a positive, and that's important, a positive test charge, Q0, at a point P near the object. Then we measure the electrostatic force on that test charge, just with Coulomb's law, and then we can define the electric field due to the charged object. And that is then defined as that electrostatic force divided by the test charge, or the magnitude there. So we're looking at SI units of newtons per Coulomb. And it will always be in the direction in which the force acts. So if our initial particle is positive, remember we're putting a positive test charge near it, so the direction will be away from the first one. So from a positively charged object, the electric field will radiate away, and for negative, it will radiate towards that. We'll look at that later. Here we have, let's just go up a little bit, electric field lines. Now, this field that pervades the space around a charged object can be represented in two ways, either by a vector, and we'll see some of that later, or by electric field lines. And the field lines are sort of a more visual representation. Now, the relationship between a field vector and a field line is that at any point, the direction of a field line, or the straight line tangent to a curved field line, is the direction of the electric field at that point. Field lines are also drawn such that if we have tiny little squares there, there's certainly more field lines in that square. So the more they are in a surface area, the stronger the electric field is. So closer to this charged object is obviously going to be a stronger electric field than further away. And by definition, we have that electric field lines point away from a positive charge and towards a negative charge. And I've already explained why that is so, in as much as we're placing a positive test charge to measure the strength of that field. If we have uniformly infinitely large plates, the electric field between them will be these straight lines that we see drawn here. In the next video, we'll look at the electric field due to a point charge.